Okay.
Play with me, Lion. I'll play with you.
I'm reading.
Well, read to me then.
Okay. Cliffhanger, hanging from a cliff, and that's
not
why they call
double cliffhanger. Read me something good.
Like what?
Like this.
You don't even know what that book's about.
Well, I will when you read it to me.
Ram in the Pepper Patch, written by Chili Ramirez. There was a gal not long ago who had some land in Mexico. She labored hard to raise a batch of peppers in a pepper patch.
One morning, about 8:30, the girl came to her garden gate and saw as she undid the latch. A ram was in her pepper patch. She watched the ram, whose name was Sam, eat peppers by the kilogram.
What's a kilogram?
Well, it's a lot of peppers. A little more than 2 pounds.
She offered Sam a yam and ham. But only peppers pleased that ram.
A passing hen was certain that she knew a way to make ram scat. She cackled,
"Scram, you ram!"
And then that hen was never seen again. A little dog yapped,
"Scram, you ram! Do I have to draw a diagram?"
He told that ram,
"Get out of here, sir!"
The dog was fierce. The ram was fiercer.
The hen had failed. So had the pup. But then a big bad bull walked up.
The bull was strong, but the ram was stronger. We won't be seeing that bull much longer.
Just then, a little bee buzzed by and told the girl she'd like to try.
I'll send that nasty ram away.
The ram said,
"That will be the day. No little bee will make me ramble, make me scamper, make me scramble."
The ram jumped up and ran away.
"I want my ma. I want my nanny. Someone stung me on the fanny."
A little bee had saved the day. The end.
Chihuahua. That stung. Oh, I got one sore fanny. Mind if I stay here a while? I mean, just until the pain goes away.
Well, I don't know.
Lionel, the poor little ram. He has a pain in his fanny.
Thanks. Gracias. Maybe I'd better not sit. I just tried to shake off this pain with a little run.
Leona, this doesn't look good.
No, Lionel, you know what? You worry way too much.
Well, that's gotta hurt.
Oops.
And now, lovers of the vowels A, E, I, O, U, and sometimes Y, Martha Reeder and the Vowels are in the house singing the short A sound from their smash word, Jam!
Ram.
Scram, ham, scram, you ham. Yeah. Don't you worry, Buster. We'll protect you from that
Rampaging Ham!
Yeah, Rampaging Ham. See, we got this sign here, and it says,
Scram Ham!
Yeah, Scram Ham.
Ham? Yeah. No, there's a Rampaging Ram in the library, not a Rampaging Ham. Mm-hmm. The sign should say, Scram Ram.
What? Oh. Ram, not ham?
Are you sure, Buster?
Yeah. I am positive.
That's funny, because
Okay, who's responsible for this? Clam! Ooh, yeah! Yam! Whoa! Cleo! Whoa, Cleo, my little meat dumpling. Let's get started.
Oh, right away, Theo, my wildebeest jerky. What's cooking today is slammed and rammed ham with no yam or clam.
My favorite.
One. Get rid of the yam and clam.
Goodbye, yam. Goodbye, clam.
Two. Slam the ham.
Ham. Slammed.
Oh, Theo, you are so big and strong, my love.
Ooh, yeah.
Three. Ram the ham.
Alrighty. Yeah. Okay. Ram the ham.
The slammed and rammed ham for 10 minutes.
Only 10 minutes?
Well, that's what the recipe says.
Well, maybe just this once we could...
And now, once again, it's time for the adventures of Sam Spud, parboiled potato detective.
The name is Spud, Sam Spud. I was working late one night. The neon sign outside my window was blinking bright, dark, bright, dark. It was about to drive me crazy when there was a knock at my door. The guy was a mess. His face looked like raw humburger. Humburger? That's not right. Not humburger. That U in hum should be an A, H-A-M, ham, and that A in burger should be a U, B-U-R-G-E-R, burger. His face looked like raw hamburger, as a matter of fact. It was raw hamburger. I could tell right away I was going to have to grill him. The guy thanked me, threw some lettuce on my desk, and told me the rest would be gravy. Yeah.
Mom! There's a talking potato on a stick with a hat on and no mouth!
Don't worry, sweetie. It's educational television. It's good for you.
Ham. Harm. Hark. Hark. Ark. Mark.
While I sing about it. Ha.
What? We gotta get this ram back in the book. But how? This isn't gonna be easy.
Oh, yes it will. You worry to...
Come on.
Oh, am. Slam.
And now it's time for
Gawain's word. Gawain here once again at Blending Fields, where two brave knights in armor will charge together
at high speed
and make a word. Competing today, we have Sir Soul. And on your right, Sir Am. Blend on, dudes.
Am. Slam!
That's Gawain's word for today. And this is Gawain saying, see you next time on Gawain's Word.
Ram. Ham. Had. Sad.
And now the Word Doctor with Dr. Ruth Wertheimer.
Hello.
Here's Dr. Ruth.
Hello, I'm Dr. Ruth Wertheimer with another word that's tired of being what it is and wants to change. So tell us, what's your story?
Oh, I'm sad. Sad! Oh, can you help me, Dr. Ruth?
Of course I can. But first, you must let go of that part of you that makes your head sad. The letter S. That's right. Let it go.
Oh, now I feel such a sense of loss.
I feel sorry for you. But now we will replace that sad S with a G and an L. And now you are...
glad! I'm glad! Oh, thank you, Dr. Ruth. Thank you.
You are welcome. Ooh, I am good.
And now, lovers of the vowels A, E, I, O, U, and sometimes Y, tap your feet as Martha Reader and the Vowels sing their fantastic hit about the short A sound.
When you see an A, crazy vowel A, and it's standing by chance between two consonants, then you say that A,
Chicken Jane. Today, Chicken Jane and the Bad Ram.
Look, look, see, see, coming down the lane. Here comes Scott, here comes Dot, here comes Chicken Jane.
Look, Scott, look. See the ram.
Yes, Dot, yes. See the ram run.
Look, look, Dot. See Chicken Jane write the letters?
S-C-R-A-M. Scram. Scram. Scram, Scott! Scram! Look, Dot, look! Chicken Jane is in the hamper.
We are not in the hamper.
Thank you, Chicken Jane!
Look, look, Cece, going up the lane. There goes Scott, there goes Dot, there goes Chicken Jane.
Dr. Bertice Berry with the A in ham!
With a short A, ah, sound in them.
Meet Annie, Annie's Granny Tammy, Danny, Danny's Manny Pammy, Sandy, Sandy's Bassett Dash, and this is Brandy. Meet Nancy, Alexandra Cabot, Clancy, Alexandra's Rabbit, Shaq and Mac and Matt and Hannah, Zach and Jack and Pat and Vanna.
Yeah, 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 what's your name?
What's your name, what's your name, what's your name?
Enjoy your name.
To remain silent. Anything you say can and will be used against you. Law enforcement. It's one of my specialties.
Click! Drag and drop that ram back into the book!
Oh, no. I don't want to go back in the book. That bee will sting me on the fanny.
No, we can't make him go back in the book, Lionel.
You can't make me go back in the book, Lionel.
Yep, he's right. You'll have to let him go, Click.
Very well, if I must...
Hey!
Executing escape!
Well, I guess I'll be going.
Yes, go! If you don't want to be the star of the story that millions of children from Mexico and all over the world have loved for generations, then go! That's fine.
That's fine?
Excuse me. Hi. I wondered if I could take out that wonderful book, Ram in the Pepper Patch by Chili Ramirez. I just love that ram. Do you have it?
Oh, I'm terribly sorry, but we only have this book. No Ram in the Pepper Patch.
No Ram in the Pepper Patch?
Mm-hmm.
Can I take a look at it?
Of course. Help yourself.
No Ram in the Pepper Patch. There was a gal not long ago who had some land in Mexico. She labored hard to raise a batch of peppers in a pepper patch. One morning, about 8:30, the girl came to her garden gate and saw, as she undid the latch, no ram was in her pepper patch. The hen and bull and dog just sat. There was no ram, and that was that.
I am one very poor
chicken. Think how bored someone reading this story is going to be.
The end? Oh, what a ripoff. I mean, there's no story here. Nothing happens. It's just a picture of a pepper patch. I'm sorry, but without the ram in it, this book stinks.
Whoa. Guess he was kind of disappointed, huh?
Well, who wouldn't be? It's a shame, really. Just think of all your other fans.
Oh, yeah. Just think.
Just think.
Caramba! I cannot disappoint my public. I'm going back in. Come on, Fanny. We've got a story to tell.
The man came back. He's back.
Thank you.
See, I told you'd be easy.
I hope this whole sorry ram episode will be a lesson to all characters from books. Stay in your stories, where you belong. And hams and other food should stay in the refrigerator, where they belong. Ugh, ham.
Between the Lions!
There are games and stories at the Between the Lions website. PBSKids.org or America Online. Keyword, PBS Kids.
Reading to children isn't just fun, it also helps them do better in school. Help a child get wild about reading. Be a designated reader.
Whoa! Okay, Daddy, I'm ready to go. Wild!
Okay.
Because we're about to read this book, son. Oink, oink, oink.
Hey, I know that book. Pigs Aplenty, Pigs Galore by David MacPhail.
Oink.
Oink, oink. Hey, what does galore mean again?
Galore, in abundance, plentiful, lots.
Oh, yeah, I remember now. Lots of
excuse me. Could we stop oinking and read the book, please?
Of course, Lionel.
Okay.
Oink. Here we go. Pigs aplenty, pigs galore.
By David McPhail.
Oink.
Late one night, as I sat reading, I thought I heard the sound of feeding. Through the kitchen door, I crept, barely watching where I stepped. A crash, a bang, a shout, a yell. I slipped on something, then I fell. I landed on a pile of pigs. Some eating dates, some eating figs. In the cupboards, on the floor, pigs aplenty, pigs galore. Black pigs, white pigs, brown and pink, making oatmeal in the sink. Pigs from England, pigs from France, pigs in just their underpants. Pigs arrive by boat, by plane. A bus pulls up, and then a train. A band strikes up. A piggy sings. Then at 10, the doorbell rings. Someone yells,
"The pizza's here!"
And all the pigs begin to cheer. Flying pizzas fill the air. One goes flat against my chair. The piggies eat their fill. I get nothing, just the bill.
I've had enough,
I scream and shout.
Get out, you pigs! You pigs, get out!
Please let us stay,
the piggies cry.
Don't make us go.
Don't say goodbye.
You can stay,
I tell them all,
but sweep the floor and scrub the wall.
I give them brooms, a pail, a mop.
Now sweep and scrub till I say stop.
The piggies work. And when they're done, upstairs they stagger, one by one. They brush their teeth and comb their tails, then wash their snouts and clean their nails. The pigs and I climb into bed. I plump the pillows, plop my head. I close my eyes and try to sleep. Before too long, I'm dreaming deep of pigs and pigs and pigs some more. Of pigs aplenty, pigs galore. The end.
Pig nose is aplenty.
Pigs. Pin. Pan. Pen. Pets.
If you can read P-E pet, then you can read pet and pen and penny too. And peg and pest, 'cause they all start with pet, you see.
Pet, P-E.
P-E at the beginning is a great big clue. And as long as you check out the ending too, you can read lots of words that start with pet, P-E.
Pet,
you can read lots of words that start with pet, P-E.
Oh.
Gentlemen, the vowels and Johnny Consonante will blend the R sound of the vowel U with the P sound of the consonant P in their smash hit word, Up!
And now, fun with Chicken Jane. Today, Chicken Jane and the Pond.
Look, look, see, see, coming down the lane. Here comes Scott, here comes Dot, here comes Chicken Jane.
Look, Dot, look, there is a rock.
Yes, Scott, yes, let us hop onto the rock.
Oh, Dot, oh, we are on top of the rock.
Let us hop on the rock top, Scott.
Hop, hop, hop. Hop, hop, hop.
It is fun to hop on top of a rock.
Look, Dot, look. Chicken Jane is writing the letters S-T-O-P. Stop.
Stop, Scott, stop. Do not hop. Look, Chicken Jane is in the pond.
We are not in the pond.
Thank you, Chicken Jane.
Bop.
Look, look, see, see, going up the lane. There goes Scott, there goes Dot, there goes Chicken Jane.
Clappy, 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 clap. Glop, slop, a doo wop, a slop, doo bop. Now with a big hit, here's Sloppy Pop.
I love the letter O when it's an O-P-R. The O in Cloppy Slop, the O in Sloppy Glop. I love the O in Mop, I really flip for flop. And nothing else can top the O-P-R and Sloppy Sloppy Pop. Don't accept the sloppy copy. Cream of the OP crop. I'm sloppy pop. Sloppy, sloppy, sloppy poppy. I love the letter O when it's an OP op. The O in clippy clap. The O in drippy drop. I love the O in hop. Ain't never gonna stop. And nothing else can top.
Have trouble, oink, figuring out the difference between next to, mm-hmm. in front of, mm-hmm. behind, mm-hmm. under, mm-hmm. and on top of.
Yeah. I wonder if there's anyone out there who could help you with this problem.
Oink?
Glad you asked. The information hen has the book you need. Now let's see. Where is it? It's a hamster's world. It's a hawk's world. It's a poodle's world. It's a panda's world. It's a hippo's world. Oh, here it is. It's a pig's world. Chapter 91, Pig and Her House. Pig is in front of her house. Pig is behind her house. Pig is next to her house. Pig is far away from her house. Pig is on top of her house. Pig is under her house. The end. Not to worry. No damage to the animated hen.
Next to.
Very good.
Okay. In front of.
Excellent.
Oh, good. Behind.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Under.
Wow.
On top of.
And now, get ready for another story about pigs. Suey?
The three little pigs.
Hey,
Lino, why are you wearing three pig noses?
Because I'm about to read you your favorite book, The Three Little Pigs.
Oh, goody!
Once upon a time, there were three little pigs. Each one built a house to live in. The first little pig built his house out of straw because it is fluffy and no fuss.
Fluffy.
The second little pig built her house out of sticks because she was in a rush.
I'm in such a rush.
The third little pig built his house out of bricks because bricks would make a snug hut.
Bricks are such a fuss.
Why struggle so much? Come have lunch with us in the mud.
I'm in no rush.
Then one day, the big bad wolf knocked on the door of the straw house.
little pig, let me come in.
No, no, you can't come in. Not by the hair of my chinny chin chin.
Then I'll huff and I'll puff and I'll blow your house in.
So he huffed and he puffed and he blew the house in. The first little pig ran all the way to the second little pig's house. But as soon as the door was shut, they heard a deep voice.
Little pig, let me come in.
No, no, you can't come in. Not by the hair of my chinny chin chin.
Then I'll huff and I'll puff and I'll blow your house in.
So he huffed and he puffed. And he blew the house in. The pigs ran all the way to the third little pig's house. But as soon as the door was shut, they heard a deep voice.
Little pig, let me come in.
No, no, you can't come in. Not by the hair of my chinny chin chin.
Then I'll huff and I'll puff and I'll blow your house in.
But the big bad wolf could not blow down the house of bricks. He grew very angry.
I'm gonna come through your chimney and eat you.
And with that, the wolf started down the chimney.
Time for lunch.
The big bad wolf didn't know that the three little pigs had a big pot of water boiling in the fireplace.
Mmm, it smells like someone's cooking a wolf!
The big bad wolf ran away, and the three little pigs lived happily ever after.
Now, I'm
gonna huff and I'll puff and I'll hug my big brother for reading me my favorite stories. Gotcha.
House. H. H. Hose. Hand. Hog. Hug.
And now it's time for...
Great word! Great word! Excellent! Gawain here once again at Blending Field, where two brave knights in armor will charge together at high speed and make a word. Competing today we have Sir... and on your right, Sir Ugg.
Ugg.
Blend on, dudes.
Ugg. 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 Oh, yeah.
Hug. Oh, excellent. That's Gawain's word for today. And this is Gawain saying, see you next time on Gawain's Word. Gawain's Word.
Here are some words that begin with the letter H.
Hat.
Hey.
Horse. Hog.
H.
And now it's time for
those magnificent monkey cheerleaders.
Ready? Okay. H O P hop. H O P hop.
Come on, girls, you gotta hop till you drop.
Yeah. H O P hop. H O P hop.
You heard me, girls, you gotta hop till you drop.
H O P hop. H O P hop.
Do it, girls, you gotta hop till you drop.
H O P hop. H O P hop.
I told you, girls, you gotta hop till you drop.
If you can read O, P, up, then you can read bop and top. And you can read crop and drop. And you can read shop.
See, I got you starting to know every op that I'm opting to show.
If you can read O, P, up, then you can read slap and plop. And you can read bop. And you can read hop. Cause you can read op.
Here's Dr. Ruth.
It must be time for another long word freak out.
Ah, ooh, 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 Dr. Ruth, Dr. Ruth, you gotta help me. I was reading a letter from a friend of mine. It said, my dear monkey friend, that's me,
What? Do you like what?
Whoa, this. Oh, look how long this word is. I can't read it. I can't. So I can't answer my friend's question.
Ooh. It's okay. Now, take a deep breath. Start on the left and read one part of the word at a time.
Okay, okay. Oh, oh, I'll try. The helicopters.
Good. Now put the parts together.
Helicopters. Oh, helicopters. My friend wants to know if I like helicopters.
Do you?
No. I love helicopters. Oh, oh, thank you, Dr. Ruth. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Oh.
I love helicopters, too. Ooh, am I good?
Ot. 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 Hot. hot. Ooh, hot. Hot.
And now, Tammy Lionette and Jasmine Guy.
Bedtime story, honey?
Yeah, I want to hear the information hen tell the story about the pig in her house.
Yeah, me too.
Glad you asked. The information hen has the book you need. Now, let's see. Where is it? It's a hamster's world. It's a hawk's world. It's a poodle's world. It's a panda's world. It's a hippo's world. Oh, here it is. It's a pig's world. Chapter 91, Pig and Her House. Pig is in front of her house. Pig is behind her house. Pig is next to her house. Pig is far away from her house. Pig is on top of her house. Pig is under her house. The end. Not to worry. No damage to the animated hen.
Funny pig.
Yeah,
right, Lionel? Lionel?
On top of!
On top of! You got me, son! Whoa, nice door there, Mr. On Top of!
Hi, Information Hen here. Visit the Between the Lions website for lots of fun games, exciting stories, catchy songs, and things to print, plus great resources for parents, teachers, and information hens. PBSKids.org.
All kids need to be read to every day. Be a designated reader. If you help a child get wild about reading, you get a child wild about learning.
Mo, once upon a time, there was a boy named John who got his own television show, and he became one of the...
seen the lions. Come on, come in, begin. The world awaits.
Between the lions, between the covers of the book, it's time to look between the lions. Behold the tales, beyond the tales.
Behind the door, become explore. Come in between the lions, begin between the lions, here between the lions.
Pizza, pizza.
Okay, Dad, soccer time, let's go.
Oh, son! Son, listen. Lionel, I got something to tell you.
Yeah, come on, you can tell me outside.
Oh, no, that's just it, son. We can't go outside.
Yeah, cool, we're gonna play soccer indoors. That's cool.
No, son. I can't go out and play soccer with you right now like we planned.
Haha, that's funny, Dad. Come on, stop joking around.
I'm not joking, son. I'm sorry, son. Your mother had to go to a conference, and I've got to stay here in the library.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh.
I know.
Oh.
Okay.
Ah. Ah.
Lionel?
Hang on, Dad, just two more. Okay,
Lionel, I knew you'd be disappointed, son. So I came prepared. Hmm? I have just one thing to say to you.
Hmm?
Pizza, pizza.
Pizza, pizza? We're ordering pizza?
No, I said pizza, pizza.
Yeah, that's what I said.
No, you said pizza, pizza. I said pizza, pizza.
Dad.
It's a book, son.
Hmm?
Yeah, look at this. It's called Pizza, Pizza. And it's written and illustrated by William Steig.
Oh, a book!
Yes. And it's Pete apostrophe S A pizza, which means Pete is a pizza.
Oh, wait a second. Are you telling me a guy named Pizza Pizza?
Well, I'm not telling you. William Steig is.
Huh?
It's a story about a kid who was disappointed because he couldn't go outside and play. Sound familiar?
Maybe we should read this.
I was hoping you'd say that, son. Pete's a Pizza by William Steig. Pete's in a bad mood. Just when he's supposed to play ball with the guys, it decides to rain. Pete's father can't help noticing how miserable his son is. He thinks it might cheer Pete up to be made into a pizza. So he sets him down on the kitchen table and starts kneading the dough and stretching it this way and that.
Kneading the dough?
Oh, yes, kneading. Pressing and turning the flour and water that makes up the pizza crust. Well, like this, son. Knead.
Dad, yeah. I get it, yeah. I get it.
Oh, okay, son, I just wanted to make sure it was absolutely clear. Alrighty, where were we? Now the dough gets swirled and twirled up in the air. Next, some oil is generously applied. It's really water. Then comes some flour. It's really talcum powder. And then some tomatoes. They're really checkers. Pete can't help giggling when his mother says she doesn't like tomatoes on her pizza. All right, says his father. No tomatoes, just some cheese. The cheese is pieces of paper. How about some pepperoni, Petey? Pete can't answer because he's only some dough and stuff. But when that dough gets tickled, it laughs like crazy. Pizzas are not supposed to laugh.
Pizza makers are not supposed to tickle their pizzas.
Well, says his father, it's time for this pizza to be put in the oven. Now our pizza is nice and hot. Pete's father brings the pizza to the table. It's time to slice our pizza, he says.
But the pizza runs away and the pizza maker chases him. The pizza gets captured and hugged. Now the sun has come out. And so the pizza decides to go look for his friends. The end.
That book was a riot, Dad.
Yeah, I'm glad you liked it, son. Hey, I bet it made you forget all about that soccer game.
What? Oh, no, it didn't. I'm never gonna get to play soccer today.
Oh, I had a feeling you were gonna say that, son. So I came prepared. I have just one thing to say. Pizza, pizza!
Yeah, we're gonna read the book again.
Nope, I ordered out.
Pizza, pizza.
Cool.
Yeah. Oh, just put it right down there, sir. Oh, yes, yes. I got your favorite, son. Thank you very much. I got your favorite. Look at this. No cheese, no tomato, no dough, all meat.
All right.
So good, so good.
Father. T-H. T-H. 30. Thimble. Thunder. Thumb.
Hi, I'm from Houston, Texas, and here are some words that begin with the letters T-H. Th.
Thumb. Thermos. Thimbles. Three. Third baseman.
Thermometer.
Thorn.
Thank. T-H. Th.
And now, a word from world-renowned mezzo-soprano, Ms. Denise Graves.
The.
About contractions, when you take two words and make them into one. You're invited. Let's get to it. I'm excited. We'll all do it. Here is here, there is there. It is everywhere. It's contractions.
And now, another word from Ms. Denise Graves.
That.
Oh, that was amazing!
Oh. You were all back in a bag of chips, you know.
Did you hear that?
I heard that.
Oh, that was amazing.
That was incredible. Thank you.
I love that. I just love that.
T-H. Father.
Well, Lionel, you forget about that soccer game yet?
I need.
Excuse me.
Not quite, Dad.
Well, that's okay. Once again, your old man is prepared. I have just one thing to say. Pizza.
Pizza what?
Well, no, Lionel, not pizza. Pizza, as in Cliffhanger and the Three Brothers and a Pizza.
Oh, Cliffhanger? Whoa, where?
On that shelf, right over there.
Flying off the shelf once again, it's the continuing, daring, and dangling adventures of Cliffhanger! Today's adventure, number 13,333, Cliffhanger and the Three Brothers and a Pizza.
Cliffhanger, hanging from a cliff, and that's why he's called Cliffhanger.
Excuse me! Excuse me!
We find Cliffhanger where we left him last, hanging from a cliff.
Can't hold on much longer.
Suddenly, beneath him, Cliff sees three brothers with a giant pizza. Quickly, Cliff thrusts his hand into his backpack, pulls out his trusty survival manual, and begins to read.
If you see three brothers with a giant pizza, disguise yourself as their long-lost father. This should do the trick. Yoo-hoo, oh boys.
Off the cliff, and we'll catch you with our pizza.
Is this the moment of truth? Are Cliff's months of torment finally over?
Thanks, fellas.
That's not father!
And that's why he's called Cliffhanger.
Can't hold on much longer.
Whoa, that was a great cliffhanger, Dad.
Yep.
I still wish you could have played soccer today, though.
Oh, son, I know. I tried to that's okay, son. Once again, I am prepared. I have just one thing to say. Cleo!
Hi, I'm back from the conference.
Oh, Mom, I missed you so much. Dad, can we go and play soccer now?
You bet, son.
All right.
See you later, sweetheart.
Nosy.
Okay, son, here I come. I got the ball.
Pizza.
And now, coming right up, is a story that's coming right up. Thank you!
Pygmalion.
Oh, Kathy, my best friend in the whole world. Why did you have to go away? Why? Now I have nobody to play soccer with.
Excuse me, Heathcliff. I couldn't help overhearing you talking to that picture.
I wasn't talking. Oh. I was crying and talking.
Oh.
And blowing my nose.
Yes. Oh, I noticed. I gather that you're sad because your friend Kathy
moved away. She said goodbye, and then she was gone. And now I'll never be able to play soccer with her ever again.
Oh, now, Heathcliff.
Never!
Sorry. Heathcliff, listen, I know it's sad when a friend moves away, but you have to have hope that you'll see her again soon.
And play soccer with her?
Yes.
No! There's no hope! She said she was going, and now she's gone, and I'll never play soccer with her again! Ever!
You know, Heathcliff, There's a story about someone who lost all hope of getting what he wanted, but then something amazing happened. I think I should read it to you.
Oh, thank you for coming back! Oh, thank you! I had lost all hope that you would ever return! Oh, thank you, nice library lion lady!
You're very welcome. It's okay. Ready? Here we go. It's a Greek myth called Pygmalion, and it's retold by Rudyard H. Lugnut I. Ready? I think you're gonna like it.
I don't know about that. I don't have a lot of hope.
Well, I think you will. In ancient Greece, there lived a great sculptor named Pygmalion, who made statues out of stone. One day, he decided to carve a statue of a woman. It would be his masterpiece. So, he gave his sleeves a tug, gave his shoulders a shrug, picked up his favorite mug, and took a slug.
Glug, glug, glug.
Then he got to work. Did not stop until he was done. When he was finished, he looked at his statue. He thought she was beautiful, the most beautiful work he had ever done. He fell in love with her.
I'm in love.
He gave her a hug.
Hug, hug, hug.
Alas, the statue could not hug him back. This made Pygmalion very unhappy. But then he had a great idea. He would pretend that the statue was hugging him back.
Pretend?
That's right. Pretend. Make believe. Pygmalion pretended that the statue was real and that she gave him a hug. That made him very happy.
I feel so hugged. Oh, I am very happy.
But before long, pretending was not enough for Pygmalion, and once again he was sad.
Just like me!
Yes, just like you. He was so much in love with the statue that Aphrodite, the goddess of love, took pity on him and brought the statue to life.
Pygmalion.
Yes. You're alive.
Give me a hug, you big lug.
Pygmalion was so happy, he gave his statue a big hug. And his statue hugged him back. For real.
Hug.
Oh, hug.
Hug.
The end. So, Heathcliff, do you understand what the story is trying to tell you?
No.
Oh, Heathcliff. The story is telling us that sometimes things happen that make us sad, but we should still have hope that there will be a happy ending.
Hope for a happy ending?
Yes. Hope.
Okay. I'll try.
Okay.
Hope for a happy ending.
You can do it.
Hope for a happy ending.
I have faith.
Kathy? My picture came to life just like Pygmalion's statue. Wait a minute. No, it didn't. It's still just a picture. It's just my imagination.
I'm back. Wanna play soccer?
Kathy! Is it you?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's me.
I thought you were were gone for good. I thought I'd never play soccer with you again.
No, I just went to soccer camp.
See, Cliff, I told you to never give up hope.
Yeah, and now I never will.
Come on, Heathcliff. Get the ball and let's play.
Oh, oh, no, wait, not yet.
What? I thought you wanted to play soccer with me.
Oh, oh, I do. But first, I want Cleo to read you a story she just read to me. Oh, it's really great.
A story before soccer? That's one of my favorite things.
Oh, I think you'll like it.
Oh, good.
It's called Pygmalion, and it's told by Rudyard H. Lugnut the First. Here we go. G. Girl.
Gorilla.
Goat. Goggles.
Oh. Goggles. 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 Woo. Goggles. Goggles.
Hi, I'm from Houston, Texas, and here are some words that begin with the letter G. Goggles.
Glasses.
Girl.
Golf ball.
Glue.
Globe.
Grapes.
Golf club.
Guitar.
Gumballs.
G-ga.
And now here's the gospel truth about the two sounds of the letter G. George and Jean and Gail and Goldie all agree. Yeah, they love the G and G sounds of the letter G.
G, we love the G and G sounds of the letter G.
When it comes before an E or I or Y, the letter G, you know it often sounds like G. But when other letters follow, you can bet your bottom dollar that the sound G makes is good. I've got one more bit of gossip.
When he hugged the statue.
Me too.
You both love the part where he hugged his statue?
Uh-huh.
Well, the library has a book about a gorilla who loves hugging everybody.
No!
Yes, and it's on that shelf over there.
And now, fun with Chicken Jane. Today, Chicken Jane and the Gorilla.
Look, Dot, look.
See the big gorilla.
Yes, Scott, yes. See the gorilla hug. It is a big hug.
See the gorilla hug the girl.
And Scott, see the gorilla hug the guy.
Look, Dot. See Chicken Jane write the letters G-E-T. Good. Get. G-O-I-N-G. Go in. going. Get going, Scott. Get going. Look, Scott, look. Chicken Jane is gasping for air.
Yes, Dot, yes. We are not gasping for air.
Thank you, Chicken Jane.
Look, look, see, see, going up the lane. There goes Scott, there goes Dot, there goes Chicken Jane.
Yeah. Gorilla hugging Chicken Jane.
Oh. Yeah, I love that too.
Oh, hey, let's play Chicken Jane and the Gorilla.
Oh, great, Kathy. You be Chicken Jane and I'll be the Gorilla. Get ready to be hugged. Hug, hug, hug.
Now I'll be the Gorilla.
Okay,
wait. Hug, hug, hug.
Isn't love grand?
Information Hen here. Visit the Between the Lions website for lots of fun games, exciting stories, catchy songs, and things to print. Plus, great resources for parents, teachers, and information hens. PBSKids.org.
Hi, I'm Leona, and Al Franken is my designated reader today.
Get a child wild about reading, and you get a child wild about learning.
That's me getting wild about learning.
That's an impressive girl.